Hello, this is Crystal Reddick of Imago Dei Newborn Photography. Today I have a set of twins in the studio, and I'm going to be showing you one of my favorite wraps to do if the baby is not quite all the way asleep. It's a nice way to get them good and snug and help them fall asleep. So on twin A, I'll do things a little differently than I will on twin B, so you can see a few different little tweaks that I make with this particular wrap style. Okay, first starting with twin A. You'll see, first of all, I have baby positioned mostly at one end of the wrap. I have their feet and their hands kind of pulled tight against their belly. I'm going to use the short end of the wrap and tuck it around the edge of them. Then I'm going to tuck their feet up against them again. And with the long end of the wrap, I'm going to bring it across their body. I'm going to be holding some tension as I'm doing it. Just kind of adjusting the wrap for wrinkles as I go along. Making sure that hand is tucked underneath the wrap. I'm not worried about the legs at this point yet. I'm gonna then gently bring the wrap around the back of the baby. And then I'm gonna fan the wrap out back under the baby's back. I'm gonna bring it one more time across the front of the baby, just making sure there aren't any wrinkles, that it's smooth. And one last time around the back of the baby. Now I'm going to pull the wrap up by the baby's shoulder. And I'm going to bring the wrap down and around the bottom. This will help tuck the baby's feet up nice and cuddly against their tummy. Nice and snug. I'm going to keep bringing the wrap around the circumference of the baby. Gently pull behind the baby's head. And then down and around again. All the time I'm just pulling the wrap nice and tight. Whatever point you run out of wrap, you can just tuck it behind the baby. And then the weight of the baby will just hold the wrap in place. Now for twin B. So once again, you'll notice I have the baby positioned mostly to one end of the wrap. I'm going to pull the short side across their tummy. I'm going to use it to capture their elbows. Then I'm going to pull the long side across and try to capture the baby's elbow and knee as I go along, trying to leave that hand up by the baby's face this time. Now I'm going to tuck that other little knee under, also under the wrap, just pulling tension against the wrap, fanning the wrap out. I'm going to gently pull the wrap back behind the baby and pull tension against the wrap again. Again, I'm just going to take the time to tuck that little knee under. Now I'm going to fan the wrap out. And I'm going to make one last pass in front of the baby. Just smoothing and fanning the wrap out as I go along. I'll start to position the baby's hand up against their cheek. Right, one last time around the backside of the baby. I'm going to pull the wrap up by the baby's shoulder. And now I'm just going to bring the wrap down and around the circumference of the baby. Again, this will just help keep those little feet tucked up tight against their tummy. This baby's feeling nice and snug. And gently bring the wrap back behind the baby's neck one last time. And then down around the baby, and just whatever point you want run out of wrap, you just tuck underneath the baby. Now you see I had twin A already just laying in the prop, and I had a parent spotting twin A while I was wrapping twin B. Handed twin B off to the parent now, and I'm going to move twin A over to allow room for the second twin. Just making minor adjustments to the wrap, to the headband. Now I'm going to add twin B to this image. Just straighten the wrap, tuck back behind. Now I'm going to go ahead and make the final adjustments to the baby's hand. Just trying to flatten the fingers up against the cheek. And then here's the final shot. Thanks for watching. If you like what you've seen, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm going to be adding more videos soon. And like my Facebook page. Thanks!